Welcome you all students of class 9, day 3, subject science, chapter number 8, motion. Topic for today is motion law derivation. So we're gonna derive how a 3 different law can be derived using graphically. Okay. Derivation of equation graphically. Topic number 2, derivation of equation graphically. Okay, consider an object, any object like car, a bus, or a ball, or a pen, anything you can take, moving with a uniform velocity. So moving with a uniform velocity at here. Okay, in a straight line. Let it be given uniform acceleration. From here you are given uniform acceleration. Like this, your uniform acceleration is given. Acceleration at time t equal to 0. This is the time t equal to 0. When its initial velocity is u. Okay, as a result of acceleration, that is acceleration, its velocity will increase. To final velocity. At here is final velocity. That is, I have shown in a dotted line This is your final velocity. The v will increase. This is the final velocity I have drawn in a dotted line. So this is your final velocity at here. Okay, in time taken by t equal to time taken t, at a distance from here to here, you're having a distance of s. So here we have get a distance s. Okay, motion first law. This is the first law. First law is that v equal to u plus at, where v is final velocity, u is initial velocity, a is your acceleration, and t is your time taken by the object. And this graph denotes as velocity versus time graph. Velocity is in y-axis, SI unit of velocity is meter per second, SI unit of time is s second, and time is given in x-axis. Okay, I have given the diagram based on two-dimensional graph diagram. This is O, this is A, this point is A, this point is E, this point is B, this point is C, and this point is D. Okay, from O to E, your voltage is V. That is total voltage from O to A. Similarly, B to D is entire voltage is V. Okay, from O to U, your entire voltage is U. Initial velocity this much. So in this much, O to A, initial velocity is u. Similarly for D to C, your initial velocity is u. Okay, now this is the starting point of your connection. Okay, your initial velocity. Okay, gives the acceleration of the moving. Thus acceleration equal to slope AB. So slope AB, this is your slope, slanting slope or an increasing slope. This is a slope AB. Okay, and according to mathematics, slope AB equal to BC, that is perpendicular upon base, that is base. This is base AC. AC is the base, slope is AB, BC is your perpendicular. Okay, according to the mathematics. So AB slope, so we are taking as AB as slope. This is moving at a constant acceleration, result of acceleration. So we are taken as A. So AB equal to acceleration A equal to change in velocity. Okay, change in velocity from B to C. Here we are changing in velocity. Okay, how we are changing? From here to here is V, from here to here is some changes are there. So here from D to B is your entire voltage V, from D to C is U. So V minus U will give V. So V is this entire thing, this is U. So this will become V minus U, that is change in velocity. VC equal to V minus U. And AC, time. This is your time. So similarly here also will be time. So t AC equal to time t. Okay, the formula become A equal to V minus U upon t, or else A will be going this side, AT equal to V minus U. So we which put U equal to this side means V equal to U plus AT, hence proof. So I hope you understand this first derivation of how we can find it out, V equal to U plus AT through graphical representation. Okay. Derivation of second law of motion. The formula of derivation of second law of motion is S equal to ut plus half of at square. This is the formula number 2. This is the formula number 2 of motion law. So S is your total distance, u is your initial velocity, t is your time taken by the object, plus half at square. A is your acceleration and t is your time. Let u be the initial velocity. This is your initial velocity. And v be the final velocity. This is your final velocity, v. Okay, of an object And A be the acceleration. This is a acceleration. Acceleration produced in the body. Produced in the body or the object. The distance traveled. This is your distance. Entire this from here to here is your distance. Distance travel is S. In time taken is T. In time taken is T is T. In time taken T is given by the area enclosed. This is the area enclosed. This is the area which is enclosed. By the velocity time graph. This is velocity time graph. This is velocity versus time graph. Okay. For the time taken, time interval of 0 to t, from here to t, okay, 0 to t. Now this is your graph and this is your explanation how we can derive the formula, and this is your graph based on two dimension graph, how we can represent, okay. So distance covered is written in like a letter S equal to area of a rectangle. This is the area of a rectangle. This entire thing is your area of a rectangle, okay. Plus area of a triangle. This entire thing is your area of a triangle. Understood? This is a triangle area. Okay. Now area of a rectangle. So O, A, C, D. This is a rectangle. You know how rectangle is forming? Rectangles. This full entire thing is a rectangle. Okay. You already know what is the area of a rectangle formula? Yes. What is that? Length into breadth. That is a length into breadth. You already know what is the area of a triangle formula? Half. Yes. Yes, my dear. Half into length into height. Half into length into height. Yeah, right. So S equal to, what is the length? OA. Length is OA. Breadth is how much? OD. Length into breadth plus half of height BC into base. That is AC. Okay. Half of base BC into AC. Okay. Understood up to here? So S equal to T into U. That is your T. Base is your T. And your length is u, okay, half b minus u. BC is how much? V minus u. And your AC is how much? T, okay, understood up here. Now we have to change this entire thing. We already got the formula from first equation, v equal to u plus at. We already got it, v equal to u plus at. Just you have to change v u to left hand side, u to left hand side, u to left hand side. We will become b minus u equal to at. So you already know what is V minus U equal to AT. So we have to just change here. So it will become AT. So S equal to UT plus half into AT into T. So AT into T is how much? T square. Yes, right. T into T is how much? T square. So it become S equal to distance equal to U plus U into T. U into T plus half into AT square. So hence we form the formula S equal to UT plus half of AT square. S equal to UT plus half of AT square. Hence, it's true. I hope this derivation is very easy for you. Very simple one for you. Just you have to know what is area of a triangle. This is a trapezium sort of thing. Just area of a triangle formula. Area of a rectangle formula. You have to just implement over there. And this is your distance. Thus, you have to just put the formula. According to the formula, you have to just write the letters. And you have to just put the get the formula right. Okay. I hope this is very easy for you. I hope you understand this concept of your how to derive the second motion formula. Okay, and this is very important to understand how a formula has been derived. Okay, this is the third topic for derivation. Third topic for derivation is derivation of third law of motion. Derivation of third law of motion. So what does that say? That third law of motion formula is 2as equal to v square minus u square. This is the formula of third law of motion. Each formula is very very important. First law, second law and third law formulas. And this is the derivation of graphically derivation. How we can derive graphically. How we can derive this formula graphically using graphical method. So graphical velocity, time graph. Velocity is in y-axis. Time is in your x-axis. And this is your diagram which I have shown, which I have drawn. And the shaded portion which I have done in yellow color is the area enclosed. Area enclosed means this is a complete area. Complete area of the trapezium. Okay, so I have already given alphabets for each. This point is O, this point is A, this point is E, this point is B, this point is C, and this point is D. I have already given for it. And from O to A is your initial velocity, I already shown you. And from O to E, that point, this point is your final velocity V. That is V here, from here up to here. And similarly for here, B to C is your change in velocity V minus U. Okay. And C to D is your U. This is one U. Same. Okay. Now we have to derive distance S. Distance covered by the object S equal to area of the trapezium. From the figure you can understand this is a trapezium. This forming like this. So So this is the figure shows us trapezium. You already know trapezium have four sides, side 1, side 2, side 3 and side 4. Okay, understood? So area of a trapezium OABD, OABD, that is the area of the trapezium. You already know what is the area of a trapezium formula? Yes, yes, that's right. Half into base 1 plus base 2 into distance covered, that is distance covered, this much distance covered or height covered by the object from here to here, that is okay. Yeah, understood. So distance covered S equal to half into base 1 OA plus base 2 BD into distance covered or height covered, that is A into C. Okay, understood. So we have to put there all the alphabets, whatever the alphabet we have given, so we have to implement over here. So OA equal to U, OA equal to U and BD equal to V, understood, into time, that is into time, AC equal to T, because OD also T, so AC equal to T. So this is the equation number 1. So we already know how to derive first law of equation. So first law formula is V equal to U plus AT. So we can change A equal to V minus U upon T. Okay, we can also change the reciprocal, A equal to V minus U upon T, understood here. It can also further changed, okay. So we just change this reciprocal, A to A, this A will come down and this T will come up. This A will come down and this T will be going up, okay. So therefore it become T equal to V minus U upon T. Let this equation be 2, okay. Now put equation 2, put this equation in 1, put this equation in here, in this equation 1, okay. Put this equation, this term T is there. So put this equation in here. Okay, this becomes S equal to half into U plus V. U plus V. Instead of this T, we have to change the formula as V minus U upon A. Understood? Clear up to here? Then this is a multiplication sign. U into U is how much? U into minus U is minus U square. Yes, yes, right. So V into V is how much? V square. Yes, that's also right. Upon A. Upon A. Understood? The half. So your distance S equal to, distance S equal to half V square minus U square upon A. You will clear up to here. Next one. Distance S equal to V square minus U square. This is multiplied by 1. Anything multiplied by 1 is itself. The name number same will be coming. V square minus U square. So 2 multiply A is how much? 2A. Understood? Now we have to take 2A into the left hand side, 2a into the left hand side, we have to multiply with s. So formula becomes 2as equal to v square minus u square. So we get the formula like this, v 2as equal to v square minus u square. So we find it out the answer, 2as equal to v square minus u square. So it's very easy for you, hence proved. Hence we have proved using this diagrammatic formation, like uniform graph formation. Okay, this is a graphical representation. We have found out using graph how we can derive this equation, the third law of equation, through a graph. Okay, this entire thing is a trapezium. So entire thing is trapezium. Using trapezium formula, we have just implemented whatever alphabet, we just change the reciprocal and implementing the formula to get the formula as 2a is equal to v square minus u square. So I hope you have understood this concept of how to prove according to the base, according to the graphical formation. So this is very, very important too in the examination. It used to come for 3 or 4 marks, or sometimes can also come as 5 marks question with a numerical. So please try to understand depth knowledge of this. If any other clarification or any other doubts is there, I'll be clearing once the school reopens. Okay, so I hope you understand this one. Okay, our next topic is numerical question based on law of motion. Okay, this is very, very important. This always comes for 5 mark question, numerical question based on law of motion. We have 3 formula we already derived. First formula, u v equal to u plus at. Second formula, s equal to ut plus half of at square. Third formula, 2as equal to v square minus u square. You already learn about this formula. This formula is very, very important for your first chapter. This 3 formula is also coming for your second chapter, that is force and law of motion, and third chapter in gravitation also, this 3 formulas are coming. These 3 formulas are very, very mandatory, and it's very important to learn from your heart and learn so that it will be very easy for you to understand how to do numerical question based on that. Okay, this 3 formula, please learn it thoroughly. so that you won't learn again and again. In up to three chapters, these three formulas will be there. Okay. Shall we go for first question? Yeah. The question number one, a bus starting from rest. A bus is starting from rest. You move with a uniform acceleration. This is moving with a uniform acceleration, that is 0.1 meter per second square. Meter per second square is the SI unit of acceleration. The time is moving for 0.1 meter per second for 2 minutes. Time is given as 2 minutes. First, what is we have to calculate? First, the speed, velocity, the speed or velocity, the speed or is velocity acquired. The speed or velocity, that is final velocity or final speed, what is acquired by the object. Second one, the total distance traveled by the object or a bus. Total distance traveled by the bus. Okay, understood? This is the question. So what are the given term? Acceleration is given 0.1 meter per second square. Yes, right. Time is given 2 minutes and we have to change minutes to second. 2 into 60. Wow, you already know 1 minute has how many seconds? Yes, right. That is 60 seconds. So 60 we have to multiply. So 2 into 60 we have to multiply. We get as 120 seconds. Why we have to always change in second? Because SI unit of time is seconds. So therefore we have to change to second. Understood? So this is very very important to please make sure that you are converting to unit seconds. Okay, unit of every object has seconds or something. You have to change the sign. Me change karna. Okay, u equal to 0. That is u equal to 0 because bus is a starting position. For example, u equal to 0. For example, you are going to the bus stand and you are standing in the bus stand. You are just there. Bus is on a stop position and you are just entering the bus. So therefore, at that moment, your bus speed is 0. It's not yet moved. That is 0. So since the bus is at the rest position, this is 0. So using the formula, what we have to find? Velocity we have to find now. Yes, velocity we have to find. So you can use the formula number 1, that is v equal to u plus at. Okay, v equal to u plus at. We have used this formula, v equal to u plus at. So v equal to 0. What is 0? U is 0 plus what is your a? 0.1. What is the time? 120 seconds. Yeah, my dear. So 0 is the 0.1 into 120 is how much? Point just care, 0 just cancel it. 1 into 12 is how much? 12 meter per second. Yes. Yes, you're right. 12 meter per second. I hope this question is understandable to you. Now we have to find the total distance traveled. We can use any formula. This formula, second formula can be used, or this third formula can be used. This can be depend upon you. Which formula you want to learn, you can apply and get the answer. Okay. So the for using second formula, S equal to UT. U 0 into 120. Time is 120. Plus half. A is 0.1, t is 120 the whole square. Okay, so anything multiplied by 0 is 0 plus half. 0.1 into 120 whole square is 14400. Understand? That is 120 into 120 is 14400. Understood? Then total distance s equal to half into 0.1 into 14400. Therefore, we'll get S equal to half into, from here, there's 10 is cancelling. From here, 10 is cancelling. So, half into 1440. What is the answer? We'll get distance equal to 720 meter. Understood? This also will be easy. And then, let's check first third formula. Third formula is 2A is equal to V square minus U square. That is third formula. 2 into A, that is 0.1 into S. S not given. You have to find it out. V is how much given? 12. V is how much given? 12. So 12 square. 12 into 12. And U is how much? 0 square. Okay. So 0.1 into 2 is 0.2 into S equal to 12 square is how much? 12 into 12 is how much? 144. Yes, my dear. That is right. So this become reciprocal. S equal to 144 divided by 0.2. Okay. So what will the answer getting? So total distance equal to 720 meter. So I hope you understand this basic concept of how to implement the formula and how to understand the question. From the question, how can you understand what are the values given, then how to change, if a minutes is given, how to change to second. You have to understand, and basic on understanding, you have to put the formula and you have to find out the answer. I hope this concept is clear for you. Any other doubts is if you have, we will be clarifying the doubt when the school reopens. The next question, question number 2. A stone is thrown in vertically upward direction. A stone is thrown, a stone or a ball, if you're having in a hand, you're throwing upward, vertically upward. So it's moving upward. Okay, vertical direction, upward direction. With a velocity of 5 meter per second. With a velocity. Suppose a stone or a ball is in your hand the stone or ball cannot move without the help of your hand. You have to give some force. That force is from your hand. You're just moving the stone upward like this. You're moving a stone upward. You're throwing a stone moving upward with your hand speed. That speed is, that velocity is 5 meters per second using your hand. If the acceleration of the stone. So you're throwing the stone with your hand. You're throwing very fast with the acceleration. That acceleration of motion is 10 meters per second square. Okay. Now in the downward direction. Now whenever the stone is more, a stone or a ball is moving upward. Whenever it's moving upward or upward, it has to come down because of gravity. So what happens whenever gravity pulls any object down? That is why Newton study about gravity. Isaac Newton, the apple fell on his head. You know that concept? Apple fell on his head because of the gravity. So any object moving upward or a stone or a ball moving upward, it has to come down. Okay, it has to come to the reach to the ground. Any object moving to up, it has to come to the ground level. Okay, so because of gravity. So what will be the height? What will be the height? Height means how much distance total stone, how much attained, total top level, how much the stone has went. That is the height or distance attained by the stone. And how much time will it take to tear? How much time can it take to reach to the top level? Okay. Now the given solution, given term, u equal to 5. U is 5 because the stone is in your hand, and from your hand you are giving some force of speed or force of velocity up so the stone can move up. You have given up how much? 5 meter per second. Now acceleration is given 10 meter per second square. I have not written 10 meter per second square. You have to write 10 meter per second square. Okay, 10 meter per second square, that is in minus. Okay. That is in minus. Okay. Now stone is moving against the gravity. Minus is given because it is moving against the gravity. You are throwing a stone or a ball against the gravity. That means you are just opposing the gravity. You are throwing the ball upward. What happened? You are throwing the ball upward. That is why it's minus. Again, afterward, the ball has to come down because of gravity. That become plus. That is why minus sign is given. That is why acceleration is given in minus, because the stone is thrown against the gravity. That is why minus sign. So what is the final velocity? Final velocity means when the ball reaches to the top level, because of the gravity, the stone or the ball has to come to the ground. Ground touching point is zero because it's coming to the ground. That is zero. Okay. Now using the formula, we can use any formula. Okay. Now I have used second formula. I have used third formula. That is v square minus u square equal to 2as. That is third formula which I have used. Okay, why I have used this formula is a basic small hint I have to give you. Why I have used this formula? Basic simple hint is because v is 0, is coming to the touching ground. So I can use this formula. It will be very easy to simplify. Okay, very easy to simplify. If I go and use second formula, that is s equal to ut plus half of at square. Why I have not used that formula? Because we have to find the time. Because we do not know what is the time. That is why I have not used second formula. So that is why I have used third formula. V square minus u square equal to 2as. Okay. What is the v? V equal to 0 square. What is the u? U is your 5 square. What is the 2as? 2 into 10. 10 is your acceleration and s is not given s. So 5 into 5 is 25. 2 into minus 10 is minus 20 s. So we have to change. S equal to reciprocal change. S equal to how much? 25 upon 20. Minus and minus cancel. So S become 1.25 meter. I hope you understand this. So second question is given, how much time will it take to reach? Uske baad second mein pucha ki kitna time hame, how much time will be there? Okay. So second question is asked, how much time? So we can use any formula. This formula can be used or this formula can be used. Okay. So I am using first formula. V equal to U plus 18. So 0 equal to U is your 5 plus 18. 80 is how much? This much. 10 into t. So 5 plus minus 10 equal to t. So 5 I am jumping to left side. 5 I am changing to the left side, that is left hand side. So it become plus 5 will become minus 5. So minus 10 t. So therefore t equal to minus 5 upon minus 10. Minus minus cancel. So it become 1.2. 1.5 is 0.5 seconds. Question for practice. This is a question for practice. I hope you will spend at least 5 to 10 minutes to do this question. So it's very important to understand how to do. The question number 1. A train is traveling at the speed of 90 km per hour, brakes are applied so that it's produced uniform acceleration of, how much acceleration is produced? 0.5 meter per second, that 0.5 meter per second, okay. Find how far the train will go before it is brought to rest. Before it is brought to rest, that means a train is traveling at a speed of 90 km, that is your U is, initial velocity is 90 km per hour. So 90, you have to change kilometer per hour to seconds, okay, understood? The brakes are applied, so brakes are applied to produce an acceleration, uniform acceleration minus 0.5 meter per second. The acceleration is this much. Find how far the train will go. How far means distance. Far means, far is known as distance. How far means distance. Is brought to rest. So rest means your position is zero. Now your train is at rest position. How far? So V becomes zero. So you have to find out the distance. So let me tell you how to find distance. U equal to 90, A equal to this much, and B equal to this much. So you know how to find it out using the formula. I hope you can do by yourself. Second question. A motorcycle running at a velocity of 72 km per hour. So motorcycle is running at this much. You have to change kilometer per hour to meter per second. Is brought to rest. Time is given 2 seconds by the application of brakes. So brought to rest. Is coming to rest. The distance covered by the motorcyclist. You have to find out the distance covered. Okay, you have to find out the distance covered by the motorcycle in 2 seconds. These are the 4 options. In the 4 options, you have to find out which is the right answer. Okay, 40, 10, 25. Brought to rest means your V also will be 0. Okay, understood? Now, question number 3. The water falls from the dam into turbine. The water is coming from the dam into the turbine wheel. Okay, wheel is having 20 meter below. That is height. 20 meter below. That is height is given 20 meter below. Then the velocity of water at the turbine is what will be become. Then the velocity of water at the turbine is what? Okay, you have to find it out. The option is given 10 meter per second. You have to find out the velocity of how much will be coming down. The velocity of the water which will be going to touch the turbine. Second option is given as 100 meter per second. C option is given as 40 meter per second. And D option is given as 20 meter per second. Understood? Okay. So I hope you will do this question properly. And any other doubt, fill in for the calculation, please ask me when the school reopens. So I hope you understand this. I hope you understand this concept of today. I hope you are safe and be healthy. Thank you for listening to my today's class. Have a good day. God.